Good morning, ducks! Are you coming? It's not raining out yet, duck. Come on. Come on, let's go. Come on, I'm going out. Doug, I'm going out, so you gotta come with me. Come on. Come on. Doug, come on. Oh, what a dog.
You know, when you get up at 5 to 4 in the morning, you never get a lot accomplished by 8 a.m. So the plan of action today, guys, is I'm going to do a bunch of little jobs around the pen. That's why I woke up at 5 to 4. My head was going 100 miles an hour because we're so close to getting the pen done, and I'm so excited. So I'm going to do a bunch of wire work on the bottom, and I'm going to shovel some gravel, and I'm going to bring some stones in, fill the trench up. I can't do the merge of the pens, because we've got a crazy rainstorm that's supposed to be coming here. They're talking like we're gonna start seeing showers around noon. They're talking like anywhere from 40 to 70 millimeters. So we're talking anywhere from like 1 3/4 to 3 inches of water today. So the ducks going out. So I'm gonna open up the big gate. Lots of ducks. There was no predator action last night. Everything seemed to be quite calm. Oh, a dead duck. I found this duck last night, but it wasn't in the best shape, and it's dead this morning. Damn. We've got ducks. Duck, you're not coming in there. Sit. Stay there. Can you be good? Stay there. Okay, duck. Here. All right, the rest of the ducks went to the far corner because they're confused. Dougie, you're vibrating like a milkshake machine here, a pan shaker, actually. All right, ducks, come on over. They're over in the other corner. Yeah, they're not cluing into this. The gate's open over here. Oh, they're coming. Come on, ducks. Come on, everybody. Actually, Disco's limb's getting way better. Alright, they're just not cluing into this, the big gate thing. Alright, let's open up the little gate. I can feel the moisture in the air. Like, I think it's going to start raining earlier than what the weather station says. Well, that was a pretty good rush out of that gate. All right, I'm gonna open up the gate here, and I gotta deal with a dead duck. This poor little duck, I found it last night over, actually on the other side of the house, and it wasn't doing too well last night. It was head slumped. It looked like it was asleep when I found it. By the grid, at the hot tub. And I picked it up, and it was like, had life. It was kicking, and it was doing all the duck kind of stuff when you pick it up. But it didn't make the night. Well, that happens. So I don't know if these guys are going to come out or not. Oh, the snapping turtle duck, his clubfoot. Look at that, eh? Everything fell off, and it's just a stump now. and he's a good sized male, but he's lost his foot. But he's doing better. Last night I saw him walking around the yard. All right, ducks, are you coming out? It's gonna rain today, so if you get caught outside, you're gonna get soaked.
Actually, I'm gonna go into the barn and do a check here, and then we're going down to the swamp to see if my minnows worked. Let's see what's going on here. Make sure there's no other dead ducks.
All right, ducks, what's going on in here? Oh, it's looking good. We got no dead ducks in here. No, this is the duck that I keep mistaking as Stripper. And it turned out last night I caught it, and it has been attacked by something because it had a big gash above its wing that was all healed up and was scar tissue. They want to come in and eat baby food.
That's why it was limping, and I kept mistaking it for Stripper, is because it had some damage, and I didn't know till I picked it up, and it had a big giant scab on its shoulder. But other than that, there's no marks, nothing else on the bird. But if they want to come out, they can today, because I'm out here working. But the rain, you can feel it in the air, like it's just, it feels wet out. That's what it feels like right now. It just feels wet.
Oh, they're coming out. Not all of them, because the rest are in the barn still. And we're gonna go out for a little run here in the yard. All right, let's get this happening.
Because I got to get some work done here before the rain starts. Oh, they're already at the creek. All right, let's go down to the creek and see how the turtle situation is. I got to put the camera inside just in case it does start raining. Well, I'm down there and I got the big camera hanging somewhere outside getting wet.
But they're leaving. They're going to the lake. Well, there come some babies. They're coming out too.
Okay, let's go to the creek. I feel positive today. I'm bringing gloves down just in case there's a turtle in the trap. Oh yeah, it's gonna start raining any time. I don't know how much I'm gonna get done here, but I want to get some wire work done on the bottom of the pen, because I've got to go long, and things like this, like when the wire comes up like this, what I got to do is I got to snip it and then overlap and tie it together so it's flat. Yes, Doug. And on the corners, I've got to put a piece of wire on this and join it together. And then I'm going to put gravel on top. That's the plan. So I've got to go down here. There's a bunch of spots where it's wowing, and I've got to trim the wire and overlap it. So I thought that's a good job to do today, because I can stop in the middle of it when it starts raining, and it doesn't matter. But let's go check our turtle trap. All right, do we have a turtle? Okay, Dougie, let me through. Oh, she's getting harder and harder for me to walk out here. Nope, still no turtle. But you know, considering we haven't had a turtle attack on a duck in a while, the turtle could be moved to the other side of the lake. And as far as the trap being deep enough in water, guys, it's deep enough. The door works, and you know, the turtle, you know, can still get in there through the other side, get to the bait, well, the bait area. And I know for a fact, guys, that the turtles are here. This is where they're getting attacked, because I watched a turtle grab a duck there on the rear end, and I couldn't do anything about it. And then that turtle I told you a couple weeks ago there, where the bum got ripped right out and the guts were hanging out, and I was digging gravel and I heard it screaming, it was getting attacked over there. So I know this is the turtle area. And I can't go out on the lake because as soon as I put traps out in the lake, I have to have a fishing license. Because my authorization from the Ministry of Natural Resources is the creek only, because the creek is on my property. So I'm allowed to trap the nuisance turtles on my property that are hurting the ducks. But as soon as I go out in the lake, I have to have a license, because that is technically harvesting, because it's not on my property. Unfortunately, that's the law. And because everything's videotaped here, and you know, I don't really want to put up the evidence on YouTube for me to get a charge. So I have been given instructions in writing from the Ministry of Natural Resources. The conservation officer told me what I can do, and this is exactly what I can do. And I know for a fact the turtles attack the ducks right here in the creek in this area. So we just gotta wait till the turtles come back to this area. Which right now they seem to have left us. Look at the ducks going crazy out there. It's gotta be minnows right here that's causing the ducks. Duck back. It's gotta be. Because they just instantly were in this area when they first came out. Doug, heel. Listen, be a good dog. It's got to be minnows. They're trying to catch the minnows. Yeah, this rainstorm that's coming, it's a good one. It's supposed to start raining somewhere around late morning, like they're talking 11, 12 o'clock, and then it's going to pour for basically 24 hours. Which we know when it starts raining, the ducks will come home and destroy the yard. Look at them going. It's got to be minnows. Oh yeah, I can see the minnows. You can see the little ripples in the water. The minnows are heading down the creek here. They're trying to get away from the ducks. Yeah, that's what they're doing. The ducks are hunting the minnows. Oh, the ducks are going to get spooked now. Dog, come here. Go, you little sneak. Come here. Come here, Doug. You're a rascal. All right, let's go do some work. All right, guys. I'm going to go shovel some gravel, do some wire work, try to get some things done before it starts raining. But tomorrow, absolutely supposed to be gorgeous. So let's go get some work done. Oh, I just felt raindrops. I don't know if it's turning out in the video, but I can see the minnows swimming down the lake, or down the lake, the creek here. They're trying to get away from the ducks. Just look at the minnows going. There must be a ton of minnows right there. The ducks are going crazy. Oh, Doug's going over to screw it all up. All right, I'm going to go do some work. And the bulrushes, guys, I'm going to try again. I'm putting another ad, a local, you know, labor ad, Kijiji here. I'm going to shoot for Wednesday next week. I'm hoping to get 2, maybe 3 guys here, plus myself, and absolutely clear cut this in one single day. That's the plan, you know, because I can't spend another, you know, 7 days cutting. We got to get on with the show here. And well, one, I want the drone action. I want to start getting some drone footage of the ducks on the lake, and spending 57 hours cutting this again. I just can't see how you'd find it entertaining. I certainly don't. But I just can't believe how well they're growing this year. Oh man, but it's been a really good summer for everything growing. So that's the plan next week. And hopefully I'll have the pen done. Oh yes, another thing too. I forget who it was. Rover Pilot sent me a link about a guy that's got Chinese geese. Now, the thing is, it's a 5-hour round trip. They're down by down by Durham. I think it's the Durham region. And according to the map on Kijiji. Now, I sent an email off to them. They've got Chinese geese. They're advertising them anyway. So I'm going to see what they want for them and what they got available. And if they do, I think we need to rally up some support. And I'll go rent a car. Well, something that I can fit, some kind of cage into or a box that I can bring these geese home. And we're going to go on a road trip and get some goosely replacements. Because I'm missing the loud, obnoxious honk. I'm not liking it, actually. Doesn't sound the same, you know, because you don't realize how loud Goose Lee was until he was gone. It's like, you know, I got quacking, I got the emdoms, which, you know, you can hear right now, but I just don't have that ear-piercing honk. So that's the update on the Goose Lee replacement. Hopefully these people have something, and if they do, we're gonna have to come up with something so that I can go get them. So when I know more, I'll let you know. And then who knows, maybe next week we'll be doing a road trip after the pen's done and after the swamp's cut. But I absolutely have to get all of this cut again. All of this has to be cut, because now we're going to be in full predator season here shortly, because that's, you know, late August, September, October is when the Mother Nature's killers come out and try to wreak havoc on the ducks. And with what I've learned, if I do this, maybe I can eliminate duck losses. I'm pretty sure I can, guys. Especially with Doug. He's so awesome this year. And if we can get, some serious prevention happening here, you know, maybe we can have an awesome fall with no loss, or very, very little loss. All right, I got to deal with that dead duck in the pen, and I'm going to start doing some wire work here. Well, this is the job I should have done like 10 days ago, guys. I got to run a sewer pipe through there for the drain for the tub. I should have done this before it got so grungy. Well, I guess I got no choice now. Well, I'm going to have to revisit this situation after I get the pen done. So I'm just looking at the way I have to put the pipe through. And I know this pipe I have to move over once the water station is moved. So I don't know how it's going to flow, and I don't really want to redo it. So onto wire. I'll do this another day when I take that wire off and, like I said, get rid of the water station right there. So on to the next job. It's just starting to sprinkle rain, so I thought to myself, Matt, I should do my chores right now to get ready, because if it starts pouring, I hate doing chores in the rain. But look at the mess here. So I'm gonna clean this up, and I'm going to put it over where the ducks will eat it. You know, they won't clean this up, but take it over to the other side and they'll gobble it all up. I can't believe how much food was on the ground. I think this is 2 days worth. It's ridiculous. But we know they'll eat it if it's out here, because it tastes better out here. Look at the pile of food. Look at that. See, come over. Oh man, ducks. I think it's going back into the pen. They don't want to go into the pen. Silly animals. I'm trying to work and this dog is like seriously harassing me for love. Doug, you're a goof. I'm bent over here trying to bend wire and he's sticking his face into my face and he's trying to give me kisses. And so this piece had a hump, so as you can see, like when I cut it, there's a slight overlap, which is not enough for me to twist wire, so I've got to take another piece of wire and put it over top. And I've got a bunch of old wire here that, oh yeah, there's my helper. Oh, Doug, it's really hard to work when you're butting in. The dog seriously wants attention. So anyways, I've got to take this, I'll make a little piece to patch it together to hold it flat. And that's what a patch job looks like. And it's brutally hard on your hands, twisting the wire, even with needle nose pliers. But you want to get it as flat as possible so that when you get the gravel on top, it doesn't hump up and give you something to catch on, one with the lawnmower or the plow in the winter. This way it stays nice and flat. On to the next one. On to the corner now. And Doug is sticking to me like glue here. Dougie, I think it's because I'm at his height here today. He's mauling the crap out of me. So what I'm going to do on this one is I just put a small piece on here, join it across to here, basically fill this hole in. That way it gives it a better edge, because this right here, lawnmower catch it. Even though I'm going to put gravel on top, you know, things can happen. It can bend up, and this way it stays flat. I have found that if you can keep it as one piece by mending wire into it, less chance of catching it and having it get all bent up and twisted later on. Well, it's starting to rain, guys. I don't believe this. I was hoping to get more done. The little ducks over there are going to be in for a shock when it starts pouring. They won't know what to do. The thing is, the sky's not that dark right now, so I'm hoping it's not going to start pouring too hard here. But I am getting wet, and it seems the ducks are getting worked up here. It's the rain, huh? They're getting ready for a party. I'm surprised Doug is hanging around with the rain coming down. It's not like him. These little ducks just came back from a swim. They're certainly being adventurous, considering this is really only their second day out. The rain's holding off. It's not holding off. It's coming down, but I'm just sucking it up and staying wet, getting wet, whatever you want to call it. Doug is a total pain, though. We know the princess doesn't like the rain, so he's coming over bothering me. I think he wants me to open either the back shed or the garage for him. He's not liking it. Oh, poor Doug. A little bit of rain won't hurt you. But the ducks are really loud. Like, the rain is causing the volume in the yard to get pretty intense here. If you had a problem with quacking ducks, my yard's not where you want to be right now. They were down in the creek, playing in the water. I love when the little ducks are just learning about the surroundings. You know, they're really cautious, but yet their curiosity gets the best of them. All right, I'm on to the far corner now, and then I'm going to shovel some gravel in the rain. I'm not going to bother with this section here yet because I've got to make a piece to go down to stop the critters from going up. Doug, oh, the rain. It isn't the end of the world, dog. You wouldn't believe what I just went through, guys. I was down there doing the corner wire. Oh, sorry, guys. I'm just a bit hyped here. I heard the ducks flutter. I turned around, and there was a coyote, a gray one, trying to get the ducks. He took off. I ran up to the house, got the rifle, went back down, and then as I was going back down, I look up, and at the mouth of the creek, there was a brown one. So I've just spent probably the last hour standing in this rain. Well, look, I'll show you how much water is in my bucket. Look at that. That's how long I was down there, standing there, getting soaked. So I'm actually frozen now. I'm just shivering. My gun is absolutely just soaked to the... I got to clean it, oil it up here. But I got to change. But I just fired off 5 rounds, just in case he's still there, because there's all those young ducks are down at the creek, and they won't come back. They're playing in the creek right now. And I thought for sure the coyote was going to come out and get those, because that's where I saw the gray one when I first looked up. And even with all those little ducks right there, he wouldn't come back out. But the adults were freaking out. Like, he was around the edge, but he wouldn't show himself for me. But there's two. A brown one, same color as the one I shot the first there, and then a gray one. Anyways, I gotta go change. I'm just shivering. I'm so soaked. It's unbelievable. I'm frozen too. Oh, man. Well, I almost got the wire done though. But I gotta go get some more ammo, and I gotta clean the gun, because it's absolutely just like absolutely soaked. Actually, I could barely even see out the scope. The water is just pounding down on me. But I'm really cold right now, so I gotta go change.
I put Doug in the house when I came to get the rifle.
He was running back and forth down to the swamp, but it's like they weren't showing themselves. I gotta grab some more ammo. I wanna shoot some more rounds off before I clean the gun. I gotta oil it up. And those little ducks are still at the creek, and they won't come back. Anyways, I gotta go shoot some. Sorry about that, guys. So anyways, I gotta go shoot some more ammo off just to make sure. I gotta put a raincoat on this time too. Man, I'm soaked. Well, my hat is dripping water. And the thing is that when I... No, Doug, stay there. When I first... No, Doug, back. When I first came to get the rifle, it was only like a little bit of rain coming down. Well, I was doing the wire. And it just started pouring, of course, you know, when I'm standing there. And I couldn't, the camera was in the pail, and the pail's filling with water, but luckily I had the pivot heads inside the case, so they never got soaked. But two of them, a gray one and a brown one.
All right, guys, I got a fresh hat on, a jacket, which I wish I would have had. Because even if the coyote would have showed up, see, here they're all coming back now. Oh, they're a little bit panicked too. See, the ducks were trying to come home, and the coyote headed them off. And of course, you know, this is how hard the rain was coming down. And I'm standing here with a t-shirt on, no raincoat. Like, look at the swamp, guys. She's just coming down hard. Actually, the stripper's down here. But they're using the tall bulrushes on the other side of the creek to ambush the ducks. I am so cold. I just stood there. Oh, there's an otter. Oh, I don't believe this today. Okay, we got otters and coyotes on the same day. and a rainstorm. But that's right where the gray coyote was. I was bent over doing the wire and I heard a bunch of kerfuffle going on. I looked up and as soon as he saw me, he took off though. Okay, ducks, go home. See, the young ones, they're too stupid to go home. So that's why the ducks were freaking out coming home. The otter's here. Oh boy, she's getting hard to walk through here. And it was right in this area that I saw the brown coyote. And he was maybe about 6-7 feet into the bulrushes. So I couldn't see a really good view of him. There's the otter. Well, putting a jacket on was a total waste, guys. I just went to my chest in water. I fell through a hole. But once again, we've got three otters that are attacking the ducks. I don't think they got a duck because I saw all three of them swimming. I didn't see any dead duck action. What a crazy afternoon. Two coyotes and three otters. And a snapping turtle that won't go into the trap. Oh, now I'm really soaked and cold. I don't believe this. Well, I definitely gotta go and clean my rifle. It got submerged too. Man, just come. The rain's coming down good. Just like they said it would. I gotta get these young ducks to come home. I don't believe that hole I fell in. I have fallen in a lot of holes here. And usually, you know, waist. That's usually the deepest that I've ever fallen. And this one, I just kept sinking and sinking. And I was like, oh, and all of a sudden my rifle was underwater. Oh, I gotta get these little guys home. Oh, just fell through another hole. Oh, this is bad today. All this water. Everything's really soft. Oh, I keep going in holes. It's not like I can get any more wet. Well, I gotta get this pen done real soon. And I gotta put the ducks in lockdown. And I've gotta do some serious patrolling. Okay, you crazy little ducks. Come on home. See, the thing is, they don't know enough yet to come home. Fire some rounds off here and come on, let's go home. All right, you don't move much. Come on, ducks. We got a bad situation here and you're not making it any easier on me. All right, this is not even working. Holy molies, everything's really, really soft. Okay, come on, guys. Let's go home. I know you're having lots of fun. Your first day down to the creek. But you couldn't ask for a worse day to be your first day. I wonder where Bill is. I gotta find Bill. And the thing is, if it wouldn't have been raining today, I would have had the rifle close by, not in the house. And I could have got at least the second coyote. Wouldn't have got the first one. He disappeared pretty quick because I was on my knees doing the wire. And when I got up, he took off as soon as he saw me. Come on, ducks. Let's go home. Come on. Okay, come on, you guys are a little bit thick. Let's go. They're soaked to the bone. Sort of like how I'm soaked to the bone. Okay, ducks, it's not stop out here. Let's go, come on. Back to the yard. You guys are like perfect coyote bait. And you didn't do a very good job for me because I thought for sure the coyote was gonna show up. Come on, little guy. I know, right? The mud's hard to walk through. You got yourself down here. And now you're struggling to get back. Come on. Let's go. We'll go slow. Come on. He keeps taking rest. Whoa! Okay, just fell in another hole. I gotta pick this duck up. Oh, man. Okay, you're not gonna let me pick you up, are you? Come here. You're having a hard time. I'll carry you. Who else do I have to carry? Do I have to carry you? No. Okay. Come on. Oh, your little heart's just a pounding. All right. I'll help you. No. Okay. Oh. It's hard going through this mud, isn't it? I'll wait for you. I'm not going to push you. Oh, man. What a day. Come on, little duckies. Okay. See, you're not going to let me pick you up. I'm not going to give you a walk home. What a crazy day, guys. Oh, boys. Doug's up in the garage. Okay, come on. Okay, the mud's hard to walk, isn't it? Here. Oh. You won't let me pick you up. All right. You're going to let me pick you up, aren't you? Okay, that little duck just threw mud in my eyeball. Come on, guys. Because Matt needs to have a shower. He's completely... Come on. Come on, little duck. I've got swamp duck all through me here. Come on, let's go. See, the first day, they played so much in the water, they're all exhausted. What a crazy day. Look at them, they're going back down to the water again. Your little heart's just a pounding. I gotta look for Bill. Because I know Bill has to go into the barn. Oh, what a mess I've created here, guys. There. I think what I gotta do is I gotta get all the ducks up into the main pen area here. I need herding sticks. Okay, I've got the herding sticks here. I'm gonna try to get the little guys up to the barn. Still no sign of Bill. Look at the water, guys. She's raining good. Okay, ducks. Come on. Let's go. Look at this, they're going back out. My boots are full of water. Come on, ducks. Today's turned out to be a bad day for letting you guys out. Actually, you know what? It would have been better if I would have left everybody in lockdown today. But I thought, you know, I was out here working. But I'm really worried here, guys, because I don't see Bill anywhere. Okay, no ducks. Come on. Okay, let's go. Oh, you guys, back to the swamp. No. Let's go. Come on. Oh. Come on. Let's go, ducks. Let's go, little guys. Come on. And the thing is, the last place I saw Bill was right there when I was doing the wire. Come on, you little rascals. But I know what I gotta do. I gotta put a tarp right there on the tree. I gotta cover that side of the tree with the tarp and get rid of some of these branches, because that's where I gotta sit and wait for the coyotes. I got an old camo tarp I'll put there. Come on, let's go. Come on, ducks. Yeah, I know you're tired, but the barn would be way more comfortable for you. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Go, ducks. Come on. Come on, you little gangly thing, yeah. Still no sign of Bill. I just found Bill. Bill's the only smart one. This is brutal. The little ducks keep going out here to the swamp. For some reason, Doug just came out of the, where is it, Doug? Are they back? They shouldn't be, with the amount of ammo I just shot off. Come on, little ducks. Ah, they're getting out of the barn again. Duck, no. No, duck. Come on, ducks. Yeah, I know. You want to stand at attention in the rain. Okay, let's go in. Oh, you little sneaks. Come on. Let's go. Okay, they can't get out. I gotta go get the rest of them now. All right, where are the rest of them? There's a bunch more, I know it. Look at that, I almost got that done, guys. I was down here on my hands and knees, bending the wire, and I heard the fluttering of the wings. I looked up, and he was right there, but he didn't have a duck in his mouth. But as soon as I stood up, he took off. And then I got the rifle up at the house. I came running back down. I was at the corner of the shed, and that's when I saw the brown guy. But it was only a flash. Same color as Doug, identical color actually. Because I did a double take, I thought, okay, Doug can't be there. I just put Doug in the back room. Okay, there's got to be, there's another little guy. Oh, I know, there's water everywhere. You're not going to cooperate, are you? Oh, she's coming down hard. All right, little duck, wrong direction, wrong direction. Wrong, 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 wrong. Yeah, I gotcha. All right, here's another little duck. Come on, little duck. Hang on. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna do one more walk around and see if there's any more. Something tells me they're still here, even though I fired off, I hit you 20 rounds so far. I'm thinking they're hungry and they're sticking close. It doesn't help when you got silly ducks down here in the water. And for Doug to be out here in the rain like this, it is very unusual for Princess to get wet. So there's obviously something out here that he is smelling. And the wind's coming from that direction. Thank you. Well, there's no other little ducks. But I'm trying to think how I could get these guys back in the pan. I'm thinking it's impossible. Ain't gonna happen with the rain. Well, I gotta change because I'm soaked and I'm cold and I gotta clean my rifle because it got submerged in water. I can't get these ducks in the pan. That would be just impossible, actually. Yeah, see, they're going back to the mud again. As soon as Doug left that area, this is really strange that Doug's out here.
White socks that are sort of brown mud color.
She's really coming down now. I gotta go shower. The inside of my pants were full of mud. My underwear are full of mud right now.
But she's coming down hard. Poor Doug wants to come in the house,
but he's really muddy. I got him in the garage right now. He's dry, well not dry, but he's, at least he's out of this crazy weather. And I tried getting the ducks into the pen. Absolutely forget it. They will not cooperate. What a crazy day. Okay. The rain has just gone down, slowed down a little bit here. The poor Dougie's in the garage here. He's not happy right now.
Oh, Dougie's.
I gotta clean my rifle. It got absolutely soaked. Unbelievable what happened today. Like, guys, it's 5:15. I just got out of the shower. Everything I had was just full of mud. My pockets from falling in that hole. I can't believe I fell in the hole and the rifle went underwater. And I didn't even get the wire done. That's the crazy part. But double coyotes though, 3 otters, and a snapping turtle. Sounds like a party. All right, I gotta get my gun cleaned out here. Get her oiled up, lubed up, cleaned out, all that kind of neat stuff.
Oh, Dougie, you're so wet. Look at you, poor dog.
Well, the rifle was full of mud. I actually had to power wash the stock. It was just caked with swamp mud. When I went to my chest, I think it was like, well, my shirt was wet to the top button when I took my jacket off. Unbelievable, what a day. Doug's been licking his foot today, and I just took a look, he cut his foot. So his back foot's got a big gash in the paw. So I've got to clean it up tonight and bandage it up because he's licking the crap out of it.
Doug, stop licking it. Hey. I know, it hurts.
He must have cut it on a rock or something, I don't know. But when I take him over to the house, I'm gonna give him a bath and then I'll put some antibiotic spray on his foot and bandage him up. We're not doing good here today, guys.
It's really wet and they're just destroying the lawn. I've chased them away and they keep coming back and drilling in that spot. And drilling there, right beside the garden. Like, they're going crazy drilling.
I can't believe how dark it is for 10 to 7. I'm gonna try turning the lights on in the pen. Maybe I can get them to go inside. Man, oh man, this rain is crazy. My rifle's cleaned, lubed up. We're ready for Mr. Coyote to show up. I bumped it against the bench, so I hope I didn't knock the scope off. I'll take a couple shots tomorrow and make sure. So if I take a shot tonight and I miss, I know why. Because I was cleaning it and I pulled out the cleaning rod and I hit the scope right on the edge of the bench. I'm hoping it didn't go out. All right, I gotta get Doug to the house and clean his foot off and bandage him up. Poor dog's hurting big time.
Doggies. You're not doing too well today. Your foot's killing you, isn't it? You're almost limping on your back foot.
When he walks on his tiptoes on that one foot. It must be stinging. I looked at it, and you can see the pad is ripped on the inside and probably stings like a bugger when he steps on it.
And don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends and enjoy the show.